Timbalan Ketua Misi Pertubuhan bagi Keselamatan dan Kerjasama Eropah OSCE di Ukraine, Alexander Huck, maklumkan pihaknya bersama pakar sekali lagi berjaya memasuki kawasan tapak nahas MH17. Pihaknya berjaya memasuki kawasan utama tapak nahas yang disebut sebagai ladang ayam dan berjaya menjumpai beberapa lagi mayat. Jangka sehingga 80 daripada 288 mayat mangsa nahas pesawat MH17 masih di kawasan ini.
We have just returned from our trip today to the crash site. It was our third day in a row where we had access to the crash site unhindered. It was a very fast access this morning, and we brought over 100 experts onto the site where work has been completed today, and we look forward to a good day at another site tomorrow.
Tugas OSCE dan pakar dari Belanda dan Australia ditangguhkan selama beberapa hari susulan pertempuran sengit antara pihak tentera kerajaan dan puak pemisah. Hal memberitahu pihak penyiasat mempunyai beberapa prosedur sekiranya pertempuran bersambung semula di kawasan nahas.
Yes, there is a procedure for the team but also for the experts that has been talked through. This is contingency planning. It is of course, as you will understand, a difficult process with more than 100 individuals on the field and over 20 cars. But that has been talked through and we have a specific procedure in place should there be a immediate danger to the site that we leave. Of course, it is our intention to leave before we would eventually be hit by anything directly, and therefore we also have this measurement. If the shelling comes closer, we then not wait until it actually hits us, so we leave before it actually happens.
Analisis awal kotak hitam dapati pesawat itu terhempas akibat ditembak.